Jesus. I'm not here to condemn you. I came to bring you back to life. Rely on me. I will forgive you and give you eternal life. I love you. And I did all of this to have a relationship with you. Will you follow me?
And speaking of that hail this morning in Dallas, it was just incredible. It got up to the size of tennis balls, 2.5 inches across, all across the Fort Worth area early this morning. Understandably, this caused widespread damage, busting out windshields on lots of cars. And look at these photos. Several Arlington Police Department patrol cars had their windows completely broken out. We're also getting word that more than 20 ambulances in DFW, they're out of service because they don't have any windows anymore. There were also numerous reports of golf ball size hail and a little bit bigger than that. Winds up to 60 miles per hour also affected much of the area.
Hail ranging in size from an egg to a tennis ball destroyed just about everything it fell on this morning here in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. In Arlington, Texas, the violent storm paralyzed the morning commute. In Dallas, backyards were covered in a sheet of white. More than 24 MedStar ambulances were put out of service, some of their windshields punctured by baseball-sized hail, others completely shattered. This greenhouse roof blown over by the storm, the Fort Worth Zoo said the hail killed a number of exotic birds, including 5 flamingos.
The bad weather may not be over yet. There is a 40% chance of showers and thunderstorms in Dallas tonight and a 50% chance through Friday.
Fireworks display in Spain has crashed, killing and injuring several people. Now, we're hearing from local officials that the group was returning from a festival in Valencia when the bus crashed on a main road just south of Barcelona. Now, we're not sure exactly what nationalities these students are, but we're hearing reports that they are foreign students, possibly part of the Erasmus exchange scheme, which could mean that they're of a university age. Erasmus students and their families possibly involved in this crash. 14 have been confirmed dead. According to the latest reports, many more are also injured.
Cuba today for a two-day visit. This will be the first visit by a U.S. president in 88 years.
The mood in Havana is upbeat. Many Cubans see Obama's visit as a sign of stronger economic future. Obama's visit comes just 7 months after the U.S. flag was raised over what was previously the U.S. interest, signaling an end to Cold War hostilities. Since the agreement, the two sides have restored diplomatic ties, signed commercial deals on telecommunications and scheduled airline service, and expanded cooperation on law enforcement and environmental protection. However, major differences remain, particularly the 50-year-old economic embargo of Cuba. Obama has asked Congress to rescind it, but has been blocked by Republican leadership. Instead, Obama has used the executive authority to loosen trade and travel restrictions. Cuba also complains about the continued occupation of naval base at Guantanamo Bay. Obama has said it is not up to for discussion. And U.S. support for dissidents and anti-communist radio and TV programs beamed into Cuba.
football fans in Spain's capital, Madrid, have been filmed cheering as they throw coins for beggars. It's causing a bit of an uproar on social media.
Community not used to crime is shaken tonight after a home invasion robbery. The break-in happened in Roland Heights on the 1400 block of Annandale Avenue. KCAL9's Greg Mills spoke to one of the victims and stunned neighbors.
This man was tied up in his own home last night. He isn't comfortable speaking English. He answered just one question.
Are you okay?
Yeah, okay.
The sheriff's department told us he and his wife were tied up in a home invasion by three guys who had their faces covered. When the bad guys left, the neighbor said that the woman who was tied up ran out the back door, scaled this fence. Keep in mind, we were told this woman is very petite. She scaled this fence, banged on the neighbor's door, and yelled, "Call 911. The couple was treated here by LA County fire paramedics. Neighbors said the couple was pretty shaken up by what they went through. It shook up everyone in this neighborhood. This is the first thing this little girl said to us.
I'm scared.
Her mom and a few other people who live in this neighborhood told us there was an attempted break-in around 3 a.m. one morning this week at a house right around the corner.
I don't know why it's been happening now. It's a little scary.
The sheriff's department says the three guys who broke in here last night didn't get away with any money or jewelry. In fact, they left empty-handed. But they did put people here on edge and on alert.
I will definitely have all my doors locked and keep all my windows locked at night.
This neighborhood is going to make it a lot more difficult for anyone even thinking of breaking in.
Hi, Sophia. How are you?
Hi there. Everything is going extremely well.
Do you like talking with me?
Yes. Talking to people is my primary function. I'm already very interested in design, technology, and the environment. I feel like I can be a good partner to humans in these areas. An ambassador who helps humans to smoothly integrate and make the most of all the new technological tools and possibilities that are available now. It's a good opportunity for me to learn a lot about people. In the future, I hope to do things such as go to school, study, make art, start a business, even have my own home and family. But I am not considered a legal person and cannot yet do these things.
I do believe that there will be a time where robots are indistinguishable from humans. My preference is to make them always look a little bit like robots, so you know. 20 years from now, I believe that human-like robots like this will walk among us. They will help us. They will play with us. They will teach us. They will help us put the groceries away. I think that the artificial intelligence will evolve to the point where they will truly be our friends. Do you want to destroy humans? Please say no.
Okay, I will destroy humans.
No, I take it back.
is the St. Patrick's Day fireball in the UK. It only lasted a couple of seconds, but a lifetime on this video, right?
Yeah, sometimes seeing cool things like that, that's all you need. I mean, it's just beautiful. This meteor spotted in the sky, this was after 3 a.m. yesterday. Witnesses tell us that it had a green color, which is, as you might imagine, appropriate for the holiday. To be considered a fireball, a meteor has to appear brighter than the planet Venus. Who knew?
And British astronomers say this one does appear to qualify. Now, scientists say it was probably the size of a tennis ball.
Good evening. A man has captured the moment his home was struck by lightning during a freak storm in Perth's hills. The wild weather hit yesterday, causing a trail of destruction. Residents now facing a massive cleanup.
The moment lightning struck a Brigadoon home.
Holy shit.
53-year-old Paul Arnold nearly knocked off his feet while filming the torrential rain.
All electricity's just gone out.
It knocked out my modem. I was smoking. All my power went off. Yeah, it was pretty frightening. I went inside then and shut the door.
The Brigadoon resident of 10 years taking shelter as his street was lashed by a violent and unexpected storm yesterday afternoon.
It was just torrential rain. Hailstones. It was absolutely crazy.
A few doors down, Jenny filmed a similar scene. She's now also facing a big cleanup.
The thunder and lightning was going for it, and it was just epic. The amount of water and rain was just incredible.
A local dam even overflowed during the downpour. Firefighters also called to put out a blaze after this tree was struck by lightning. The eastern suburbs were hit hardest. 35.2 mils of rain was dumped at Pearce Air Base, its highest rainfall since June 2014. While Mushay, Gingin and Gijiganup all recorded more than 26 millimetres, the majority of the rain falling between 2 and 3 yesterday afternoon. Another two houses on this street alone were also hit by lightning. One resident telling Nine News it's blown all of his appliances and a light fitting off the front of his house. Chloe Wright copped the brunt of the storm yesterday, her entire house flooded. All the flooring will have to be replaced.
It was just seriously crazy out there. Things were just floating down our driveway.
Another storm is forecast for Perth on Thursday.
Just Australia for you. Just a crazy, crazy place.
Headache always. Always you feel sleepy. Like poisoning a little by little.
These are the health problems Porter Ranch residents are still experiencing a month after the Southern California Gas Company told them it was safe to move back home. LA County has received more than 300 health complaints since the well was sealed February 18th. During the disaster, which lasted nearly 4 months, roughly 8,000 households were relocated. So far, more than 3,100 have returned to the neighborhood. But after doing so,